we'll put this on Facebook tonight. Amen. So I just want to thank God for my friend. We have constant conversations because the church is just backsliding. They're not living holy like they used to. Amen. The women going to church looking like hookers, and men going to church looking like women. Amen. And the church is all mixed up, so you don't know what's saved and what ain't saved. And so we thank God for the remnant that is left that's still living holy. Amen. And they think that we're a joke and that we're silly for living holy. Amen. But when the rapture comes, and that's right, Pastor, we are peculiar people. We're strange folk. Hello, somebody. But the Bible says we're set apart and fit for his use. Can I get a witness in the house? So I don't care if I'm the oddball. Come on, somebody. It doesn't matter if I'm the oddball. Amen. I'd rather be odd and saved than to be like everybody else and go to hell. Amen. Because the Bible says straight is the gate and narrow is the way that leadeth to life. And do you know people don't even preach that scripture no more? They got rid of that because they like, well, the most if you popular, your church packed out, you got to be going to heaven. The devil is a lie. I don't care how packed out your church are. If you're not preaching the truth of the word of God, it doesn't matter. That's why Paul said, I have to be careful, lest I preach to others and I myself be a castaway. In other words, what I preach, I got to live. But they don't preach homosexuality anymore. That's how they got the laws passed. They don't even preach fornication no more. Hello, somebody. Amen. A lot of churches bump and grind. Am I getting a witness in the house? Preachers drinking, people cussing. Hello, somebody. Oh, okay, they're talking to somebody here. The old saints would roll over in their grave if they see some of the saints, some of the stuff these people doing nowadays and call themselves saved. So I thank the Lord that my friend that I'm about to bring forth, he's saved. Amen. Amen. And I'm going to tell you, even though we all saved, we got our ups, we got our downs. Because we're still human, but we're saved. And I know that he's a holy man of God. Amen. So please put your hands together and give a warm Jesus is the answer welcome. And I'm going to say one quick thing. Saints, thank you. Y'all showed out. Y'all showed up. Give yourselves a hand. And let's welcome hands together for the Lord. Amen. Truly it is a blessing to be in this place on today. We give God the glory and all the praise. Amen. Thank God for the set man and the set woman of this house. Let's give God another praise. Amen. The senior pastor, amen. Bishop Ernest Johnson, First Lady Rebecca Johnson. Come on, clap your hands. Give God some praise. Amen. I do honor the Lord for the love of my life, my companion. Amen. My beautiful wife. Amen. First Lady Lydia Lyons. Come on, clap your hands and give God some praise. Amen. Just wave your hands, sweetheart. Look at her. She's looking so good. Here we go. We're getting all this message. Amen. The Lord is good. Amen. Amen. The Lord knows how to turn it around. Amen. Amen. We're going to go ahead and get into the Word of God. Let us go and definitely thank God for my brother-in-law. This is my wife's oldest brother. Amen. Let's give God some praise for fellow pastor of Canada and First Lady D Canada. Come on, clap your hands and give God some praise. They came out to support, amen. Unity of All Nations is their church in the city of, amen, South Central LA. So we bless God for them and their church family that came. We bless God for you in the name of Jesus. God bless you, Jesus is the answer. Y'all ready to have some church in this place? Amen. Hallelujah. We're going to get into the Word of God on tonight. Amen. I definitely know that there is a word from the Lord. Let's go to the book of Nehemiah, chapter number 3. That's Nehemiah chapter number 2. Nehemiah chapter number 2. I want to read verse number 20. Nehemiah chapter number 2. Praise the Lord. I'm going to start reading at verse number 20. Nehemiah chapter number 2, verse number 20. And it's something that, you know, I'm here tonight preaching a revival. And the theme is repairing the breach. Amen. And Pastor Canada, we was over fellowshipping at his church, and amen, my sister-in-law evangelist, amen, state
Canada. Amen. Amen. We thank God for Evangelist Cynthia Canada. All she was talking about repairing the breach, and I think she was teaching, she was sharing that she was teaching, I believe, in Sunday school about that, dealing with Nehemiah and rebuilding and all that type of stuff. And it's something that this is Bishop Johnson's theme. Amen. And my God, I tell you, we had some church over at Pastor Canada Church. Amen. We went over there, the Holy Ghost broke out. I guess revival is just in the land, Bishop. It's revival time. Amen. We just stopped by the fellowship, and the man of God just broke out. The Holy Ghost just jumped all over him, and he said, "We getting ready to do a revival, Apostle." I can't hear nobody. Amen. So, see, one thing about the Holy Ghost is always on one accord. I can't hear nobody in this place on today. Amen. Amen. So, we're going to have a time over there this coming week, and I'm just looking forward to that. Can you say amen? Amen. Look at Nehemiah chapter number 2, verse number 20. When you have it, say amen.
Amen.
Let's read that last verse, verse number 20, with power. Ready? Read. In the seasons, oh my God, when you need peace, come on, here, somebody. This is the time and the season, amen. But you need to befriend people that are not full of hell and confusion. Y'all ain't saying nothing to me. Can I get a witness in this place on today? Oh man, I'm telling you, you gotta get away from things that are hindering you. Oh, you did run well, but what hindered you? You know what I found out, people of God? Most greatest hindrance can be in your life is people. Come on here, somebody. That's why you have to watch who you let in your life. That's why you have to watch out for who you hang with. Y'all ain't saying that to me. That's why you have to watch out who you walk with. Come on here, somebody. Because hooking up with the wrong friends and hanging out with the wrong kind of people will slow you up. I feel the anointing in this place on tonight. Come on here, somebody. Amen. This is the time and the season to go to another level. I wish I had a witness in this place on the day. And some people, amen, I found out that you don't even need to be around. Because you know what? Some folk, they're not going where you are going. And see, some friends that you want to hang around, they don't like you anyway. Y'all ain't saying that to me in this place on the day. See, some people don't like you because of the that's on you. That's the anointing. Come on here, somebody. Some people got a problem with you because they could see that there's something great up on your life. Because they can see oh Lord, I feel the anointing of the Holy Ghost in this place on today. Lord, get away from people, amen, that always want to try to downplay you. Always want to bring up your past, and you always want to call themselves trying to be funny and making fun of you. I can't hear nobody. And always want to put their foot on you. Come on here, somebody. Amen. Okay, your past is your past. It's time to move on from that, and you keep pursuing purpose because it's already under the blood. It's time to pass. Oh, come on here, somebody. It's time to press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling in Christ Jesus. Amen. And that's what I like about Nehemiah. Amen. He said, I'm going to repair these walls. I'm willing to rebuild whatever looked like it's broken. Lord have mercy. He went back to the city and he seen that the city was in ruins from which his ancestors came from. And he said, you know what? God has released me to pursue purpose. See, sometimes God will take you back to where y'all ain't saying that to me in this place. He'll take you back to where you used to do mess, to do some holy stuff. Y'all ain't talking to me in this place. Amen. Sometimes God will do things to blow your mind. Sometimes he'll do things that you don't understand. But I stand before you on today to let you know to step out of faith and obey God. This is the season to obey God. This is the season to stretch out. This is the season to pursue purpose. Stop complaining. Stop whining. Don't worry about what's lacking. I feel the Holy Ghost in this place on the day. Oh, Lord, have mercy. The Bible says, walking in the spirit of doubt. Y'all ain't talking to me in this place over there. Look at your neighbor and say, keep your faith up. You got to keep your faith up. I can't hear nobody in this place. Lord, you can't be double-minded. Either you're going to believe God in this season or you're not. I can't hear nobody. Either you're going to move in and say, move or not. I feel the anointing here. Oh, it's time out for all the double-minded stuff. One minute you believe God can do it, the next minute you don't believe he can do it. Stop letting the devil play with your mind. There comes a time when you say, wait a minute, devil, get out of my way. I believe God can do exceeding abundantly above all that I can ask me will do. There comes a time in your life to where you just tell the devil where to go. And that's to the pits. I can't hear nobody here. Lord, there comes a time in your life, amen, where you just get radical. And say, you know what? I'm not moved by what I see. But in this season, I'm being moved by what I believe. I'm being moved by what God spoke into my spirit. I'm being moved by what God showed me in that dream. Somebody ought to help me praise him in this place. It's time to pursue purpose. Can I get a witness in this place on the day? It's time to stretch out on God. I feel the anointing in this place on the day. And you can't pursue purpose and go to the next level and be successful running with the devil. I don't know who that was for, but I'm just going to push the truth up in this place. Because you cannot run with folk that ain't going where you're going. I can't hear nobody in this place. Oh, I wish I had a witness here. You're trying to do the things of God and be successful in the spiritual things of God. And the folk are trying to get in your life and take you down. Trying to take you down to the club. Trying to get you to drink. Trying to get you to cuss. Trying to get you to do all type of crazy stuff. Trying to get you to lie. Trying to get you to cheat. Trying to get you to fornicate. But the devil is a liar.
And I'm persuaded he's able to keep that which you committed unto him against that day. Oh, he's a keeper. Can I get a witness in this place on the day? Oh, he'll keep you in perfect peace if you just keep your mind still on him. I feel you know, I feel prophecy raising up in me right now. Oh, Lord, the devil is trying to attack somebody with this.
I wish I had a witness here. Oh, there comes a time, my God, that you're going to have to cast down evil imaginations. Come on here, somebody. We're talking about pursuing purpose. You think just because you speak in tongues and just because you save that the devil ain't going to tell you to lie? The devil is a liar, right? So he won't try to get you to lie. He's a killer. He's a cheater. He's all the above when it comes to unrighteousness. You ain't strange because the devil told you to go hit a lick and turn a trick. You ain't strange. You just dealing with your flesh. I can't hear nobody here. Your spirit man is saved, but your flesh is being crucified daily. I ain't gonna keep you too long today, but I came. I said I came today to tell some people you don't have to fight to pursue purpose. You don't have to fight to get back in the race. Get back up. Because the Lord is going to restore your faith tonight. This is revival time. Somebody is going to get restored in the faith. Because God just showed me right now. Some of you, the devil been trying to steal the joy of your salvation. But I came to tell the devil that he is a liar. And he's going to lose your joy tonight. He's going to lose your peace tonight. Stop begin to happen. When you begin to pray, stop begin to move.
stretching you, stretching out on God. It makes it a little more easy to pursue purpose. You can't stay safe without a prayer life. The devil ain't just gonna sit there and let you serve God. He gonna fight you. I can't hear nobody, but I'm gonna tell you now how to fight the devil back. You gotta fight him in prayer. Pray, pray. It's time to pray. We got to pray just to make it. We gotta pray to go to another level. We gotta pray to keep the anointing hot. You gotta pray if you're gonna go higher as a minister. You got to pray if you're gonna pursue purpose. I feel the anointing.
Some folk didn't like it. See, whenever
well, you can't do this and you can't do that. Can I win this, Pastor? That's going to try to rain on your parade. I wish I had a witness. First day I'm talking to you. Some people don't want to see you blessed. I can't hear nobody here. Oh, Lord. Let's go to church, Pastor. Some people can't get your messages. I can't hear nobody here. Some people don't want to see you get married. Let's go ahead and worship.
I got a
just gonna leave you. I can hear that song. I don't believe he brought me this far to leave me. Yeah. And that's what the Lord wants y'all to understand tonight. Shoot yourself for this. Huh?
Acts chapter 2 verse 38, that you, when you now repent and are baptized in the name of Jesus, that he will give you the Holy Ghost and that you will be saved. Do you accept him as your Lord, your Savior, and your soon coming King? Amen. Is he the Lord? Do you accept him as the Lord of your life? All right, let's step right in. Right down there. All right. Here we go. Okay, block the camera. Okay. Brother Donald Henderson, according to the faith that you have in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, according to Acts chapter 2, verse 38, which says, then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of your sin, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. We do now baptize you in the name of Jesus Christ. Really? Hold your breath. In Jesus' name.
Holy Ghost.
Hey! 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 Hallelujah! Yes, Lord! Hey!
Hallelujah! Hey! Help me out!
Stories were miracles, were true blessings, were
because of God.
True stories were miracles, were true blessings, were.
I was riding in my car one day in the express lane, rolling on the freeway. And suddenly the phone rings. Then I reached down beside me. Then I looked on the floor, felt on the back seat. See, I was drinking while I was driving, never thinking about what I was doing. I turned around, and before I knew it, here comes this truck now.